Hello and welcome back. So, in this bonus video, we're going to go through the book. I've opened the game. Do you see this book here? And go. It's like a codex of the Dune universe. So I'm going to go through and read it. And some of the pages have little videos, so let's have that first. A lot of you have seen this in the intro.
A beginning is a very delicate time. Know then that it is the year 10,191. The known universe is ruled by the Padishah Emperor Shaddam IV, my father. In this time, the most precious substance in the universe is the spice melange. The spice extends life. The spice expands consciousness. The spice is vital to space travel. The Spacing Guild and its navigators, who the spice has mutated over 4,000 years, use the orange spice gas, which gives them the ability to fold space. That is, travel to any part of the universe without moving. Oh yes, I forgot to tell you. The spice exists on only one planet in the entire universe. A desolate, dry planet with vast deserts. Hidden away within the rocks of these deserts are a people known as the Fremen, who have long held a prophecy that a man would come, a messiah, who would lead them to true freedom. The planet is Arrakis, also known as Dune.
On Dune, the desert covers the entire planet. Also called Arrakis or the Sand Planet, Dune is known as the only place where the most valuable substance in the universe, the spice, can be found. Weather, no precipitations. Few natives, the Fremen, live hidden in the desert.
Here we are now, Kaladin, and 19 light years beyond Benith Lilacs.
The training planet of the Mentats, the human computers. Noah Mentat by his red stained lips.
There, Arrakis.
Spice mining. Carry all, lower the harvester to the sand, and lift it off to safety when a worm attacks. Worms attack all rhythmic vibrations. Weather. Storms. No precipitation.
Never one drop of rain on Arrakis. And the Harkonnens are near. There. Giedi Prime and the Baron Harkonnen. The enemy.
The Baron Harkonnen has sworn to destroy House Atreides and steal the Ducal Signet Ring for himself.
Poor Atreides arrived on Dune with his father, the Duke Leto Atreides, and his mother Jessica. They settled in the deep desert, in a place once occupied by their enemies. Caladan is the Atreides' home planet. Oops. Huh? What's going on here? There we go. Oops, missed one. As the Duke said to Paul, "My son, we must mine the spice as soon as possible, or the Emperor will recall us from Dune." Paul's first encountered the Fremen in a siege near the palace. Fremen are the first inhabitants of Dune. They live in sieges, hidden in the desert. Their eyes are blue, totally blue. No whites in them due to a saturation of their blood with spice. Duncan Idaho told Paul, Do remember that spice is by far the most valuable substance in the whole universe, and that it can only be found here on Dune. Paul's mother, Jessica, explains the spice is mined from the sands of Dune. Spice prolongs life and extends consciousness. It's used by the Guild of Navigators to travel through space. One Fremen told Paul, a stillsuit is basically a high-efficiency filter. Perspiration passes through the first layer and is gathered in the second. Salt is separated and reclaimed water circulates to catch pockets from which you can drink through a tube at your neck.
Report 1. No contact. Report 2.
Negative.
Report 3.
Negative, sir.
Report 4.
No contact. Repeat. No contact.
Spice. Pure, unrefined spice.
The Harvester is a very large machine used to mine the spice from the sands of Dune. Impurities are spun off and ejected through a spout at the top of the harvester. Harvesters are often attacked by the gigantic sandworms because of the machine's rhythmic vibrations. Prospecting for spice is a very particular job only very few people are able to do. Paul found such a troop and convinced them to go from siege to siege. Spice beds are located by subtle changes in sand texture and colour, depressions in sand flats, and telltale odour and colour gases. Samples are assayed by taste. This test is often fatal due to the high concentrations of mock spice. Paul's mother, Jessica, explains, "Paul, I gave you more than an education. It was more a kind of special training. I expect that here on this very special planet, you'll discover you have many special powers." God, some of the script for this game was a bit dodgy. Emperor Shaddam IV reigns over the known universe. He controls spice production and its availability to the Guild of Navigators. His soldier fanatics, the Shadowcar, who we managed to avoid, are feared in every world. He has allowed the Atreides to settle on Dune, at a time when the spice extraction was largely dominated by the Harkonnens. Duncan Idaho told Paul, "Sandworms grow to an enormous size. Specimens longer than 400 meters have been seen in the deep desert and live to a great age. Worms attack all rhythmic vibration." Paul Atreides went alone into the desert. There he had his first vision, and from this moment he was able to have visions of simultaneously important events occurring elsewhere on Dune. He was also able to mentally communicate with the Fremen and rally to him within a certain range. The Mentat Order is that class of Imperial citizens trained for supreme accomplishments of logic. also called human computers. They are appreciated for their advice in military and political matters. Mentant use their semiter? Substance that turn their lips to black and their teeth to red. Thufi Hawat is a mentat of the Atreides house. Let's try this one.
That followed, Muad'Dib and the Fremen brought spice production to a standstill.
The Harkonnens are longtime enemies of the Atreides family. Baron Vladimir Harkonnen is well known for his brutal methods of enslaving people and for his cruelty. Fade Rautha Harkonnen, the Baron's nephew, is ambitious, aggressive, and impulsive character. Giddy Prime is the home planet of the Harkonnens. Gurney Halleck said to Paul, "The armory is of great interest to me. Don't forget that I am a military training specialist. I trained you." Ornithopters are used by spice miners to watch for worm sign. The orny stays close to the harvester to effect a rapid evacuation should a worm appear.
I am Uthul, Paul Muad'Dib. Our shared enemy, the Harkonnens, are once again in control of Arrakis. Stilgar, your leader, has asked me and my mother to teach you the Weirding Way to crush the Harkonnens. We must do more than this. We must totally destroy all spice production on Arrakis. The guild and the entire universe depends on spice. He who can destroy a thing controls a thing. I will take 100 of your warriors and train them. This 100 will train the 1,000 that remain. When the spice flow stops, all eyes will turn to Arrakis. The Baron and the Emperor himself will be forced to deal with us. Arrakis will become the center of the universe.
Stilgar, the Fremen leader, told Paul, "By joining our forces, we will be able to make these Harkonnen invaders step back. We will call you Muad'Dib, the name of the mouse shadow on the second moon of Dune. Your water shall mingle with our water." The kris is a Fremen knife, whose blade consists of a single tooth from a giant sandworm.
Johnny, I love you. I've always loved you.
And Chani said to Paul, "Oh, Paul, this moment is unique, being here next to you, all those worlds above us. I want to be close to you." A worm is called with a thumper, a short stake with a spring-driven clapper at one end. As the worm arrives to swallow the thumper, Fremen run along and use hooks to get on top of the worm. The travel course of the worm is controlled by the driver hooks. Up to several hundred men can ride the same worm. Paul's mother, Jessica, explains, "No doubt now your eyes will be blue." One day, Charlie conducts Paul to her father's siege. Leah Kynes let him visit his biological station, where experimental bulbs were grown. Paul also came to know of the presence of wind traps that capture the very light moisture from the air. Patiently, drop by drop, Fremen have accumulated water in hidden reservoirs. And Gurney Halleck said to Paul, "We can send spies to discover the Harkonnen fortresses. After locating one, they can tell us how many troops there are and how we can move our troops to each fortress to attack it." Paul's mother Jessica explained, "The water of life is illuminating poison. It's produced by a baby worm when dying from drowning. It has changed within the bodies of Fremen Reverend mothers to become a spectral awareness narcotic." Paul's mother Jessica explains, "After drinking the water of life, your mental capacities have been boosted. You are now able to contact Fremen on the entire planet." And that is the end of the book. Ta-ta for now. See you